Lift! Lift! Lighten! Lighten! Four! Five mil up! Five! Catch! Four! Catch! Three! Two! One! Ten up now! Catch! Ten! Catch! Nine catches! Eight! Catch! Seven! Catch! Six! Catch!
Don't forget to scream.
My name is Doug Davis, and I guess to introduce myself and discuss what I'm going to be talking about, it's rowing, of course. If you know anything about me, you would know that rowing is my life.
Doug, your freshman year, your progression through your freshman year. Obviously, when you came out, you within a week were the top spot on the team. And through the progression of your freshman year rowing, you obviously set yourself apart from everybody else, and you were definitely set up to have a stellar career as an oarsman. So by the end of freshman year, we knew you were going to be going somewhere big. I encourage you, Doug, to join the Beach Patrol because the Beach Patrol is a great platform to not only learn, grow, and mature, but also to express athletic ability, teamwork, the idea of working well with others, and getting involved in public safety gives you a tremendous amount of responsibility at a young age. So. Getting you out there and involved in that, I felt would really help you establish yourself not only as a great oarsman, but also a team leader moving forward into your junior and now senior year. And I feel that the Beach Patrol has done and been a great experience for you, and hopefully will continue to be in the near future.
The start to my junior year is when I really started picking things up in the world of rowing, because I started to realize where it was going to take me. It was going to bring me to college, is what I found out. And I knew what I had to do, and so I really started stepping things up.
You mean grind time? Well, yeah. Our grind time, it consists of waking up, going to school, going to crew, going to the gym, get some lifts in, because you know we got to be big and handsome, and then you get showered. Everyone does their homework because we're all smart. And then we go back to school. We go to sleep, and then we go back to school and get our education.
I started the sport as a freshman, just trying out the sport and liking it. And as the years progressed, he's started going to the gym, working out, watching what he eats, and really being dedicated to the sport.
True. Doug's dedication to the sport of crew is pretty insane. I don't ever see him during crew season. It's like maybe once a month is when I get to hang out with him. He's always in the gym. He's always with the crew guys. He's always sleeping. He's never at any social events we have because he's always working out. But I mean, it's good. It's wild how much he dedicates himself to the sport.
Good things.
when Doug was looking at colleges, I let him look at the ones he wanted to and tried to support him by letting him talk to them and experience them for himself and not having my personal influence on his decision. And I think he made a very good decision.
Now as a senior, and ultimately now next year at Drexel University, I feel like all those steps in the last 4 years helped get you to where you're going to be. And I think it's a great opportunity. And I feel like those experiences help you establish yourself and get you poised and ready for it. And I think you're going to do great.
Doug decided to go D1. When I heard he was going to go Division One, and that he was looking at schools like Syracuse and Drexel and Northeastern, it was just wild. I never thought Doug had it in him to go to a Division One school. I mean, he picked up Crew his freshman year, and all of a sudden, he started junior year, and he's going to Division One. So, well, thinking about going to Division One. So, it's pretty wild. Pretty proud of him, man. Pretty proud.